Corporal Richard J. Wosnik, United States Marine Corps, citation. In recognition of courage displayed 51 years ago while serving as a rifleman with the 3rd Platoon, Golf Company, 2nd Battalion, 1st Marines, 1st Marines Division, in connection with combat operations against the enemy in the Republic of Vietnam. During this evening hour of May 5th, 1969, while the 3rd Platoon was in process of establishing ambush position, their lead element made contact with reinforced NVA company. A firefight ensued. The NVA then fired a brigade of 82 mortar rounds on the 3rd Platoon's position with devastating effects. 3 3rd Platoon Marines were killed and 18 seriously wounded. Corporal Wosnik, without hesitation, began to render aid to his fellow Marine. Butch Henshaw, he then located in the darkness. PFC Gene Warney, who was laying on the ground, bleeding profusely from a wound to his neck. Shrapnel had damaged Warney's carotid artery, suffocating Warney in his own blood. The platoon only corpsman, himself also wounded, had the difficult task of assigning triage priority for the wounded. Warney's prospects were bleak, as his wounds appeared fatal. Before moving on to access and treat other wounded Marines with a better chance of survival, the corpsman handed Corporal Wosnik a tracheotomy tube scalpel and was given a quick tutorial where to make the incision and how to insert the tube. Corporal Wosnik, knowing this was Warney's only chance for possible survival, without hesitation or training as a corpsman, performed the operation under the glow of friendly fire illumination rounds, while another Marine applied pressure to Warney's damaged carotid artery. Now soaked in Warney's blood, Corporal Wosnik observed that PFC Warney's breathing had become less labored. The emergency tracheotomy operation appeared to have worked. Then Corporal Wosnik moved on to assist other fallen Marines and help to load his wounded comrades onto the medevac chopper for transport to the hospital when it arrived. For over 40 years, Corporal Wosnik, now a retired school administrator, wondered if his actions that night had saved PFC Warney's life. In 2016, after numerous inquiries, he received his answer. Yes, Gene Warney was married and had 5 grown children. Had it not been for his courageous actions of Corporal Wosnik the night of May 5th, 1969, Gene Warney's life would have ended. His future history and that of his family would have never been written. Richard Wosnik upheld the highest traditions of the United States Marine Corps and the U.S. Naval Service. Richard Wosnik's courageous actions that night of May 5th, 1969 are hereby recognized. For 2nd Battalion, 1st Marines Vietnam Veterans, with pleasure and admiration. Semper Fi, Ted Hopgood, Major General, U.S. Marine Corps, retired.
Hey, Richard, this is your Marine Corps buddy, Semper Fi, bro. You know, the one that you saved back on May 5th, 1969, when the corpsman came by, took one look at me and said, well, I'm sure there's somebody else here worth saving more than this guy, because he ain't going to make it. But he gave you a trach kit and said, if you want to try, go ahead. Thank God you did, because I'm still here today. Kind of a hard guy to get rid of. But all kidding aside, had it not been for you, your actions, I would not be here today. I would not have the great family that I have, the great wife that I have, the friends that I have, been able to, in some ways, help other people from that day. And I know my mom would love to have known that you were the one that saved me and not the corpsman, because my mom always wanted to hug that corpsman. And she was a hugger. And you would have liked that hug. But I want to say thank you, Richard. And thank you to my friend Michael Braxton for getting us in touch. So I do know what really happened that day. And it was you that saved my life. Whatever award it is, I don't know the name of it, you deserve every bit of it, even more. Thank you again. God bless you. Semper Fi. I'll see you, bro. Okay.
Richard, thank you for serving our country and helping give an opportunity and protection to all Americans in the United States. You're a role model, a hero, an outstanding Marine, one who certainly defines, you know, the phrase Semper Fi and making sure that no man is left behind. You may not know it, but saving Gene had a cascading effect which resulted in saving and enriching so many more lives of people you've never met. It's also created life, as evident by my brothers and sisters and nephews. It's actions like yours that, you know, motivates me to want to do better, you know, because of what you've given us all by serving and putting your own life on the line. Thank you.
This is Brian Warney and Carly Warney and Baby Jackson. We just wanted to say thank you for your heroic act that you did on that day to save my dad's life. We know that there is a lot of people out there, and we appreciate you sticking with your training, your dedication, and your selflessness to save another man's life. We wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for you. We love our dad, and we are glad that he's here today.
Thank you so much, Richard.
And I want to congratulate you on your award. Congratulations, well deserved.
Hi, I'm the oldest of the Warney Bunch. My name is Erica, and this is
Jan.
My 5-year-old. I have a husband, Darren. We wanted to extend our thanks to your family for allowing us a few moments to share Richard's spotlight and express our sincerest gratitude to Richard for saving my father's life and express what that means to me. Your heroic acts that night began a chain reaction. Without your life-saving actions, my father would not be here, nor would I, or would Chance. I would not have experienced what I consider to be my greatest blessing, which is motherhood. Love is felt and expressed in so many ways. I know how much my parents love us. I feel unconditional love every day that I get to hug my own child. It's true when they say you would give your own life for your child. Not many people would willingly sacrifice their own life for someone they don't even know. What is inspiring is the unconditional love you showed a complete stranger one fateful night in Vietnam to save a wounded man who would have otherwise died. It's hard to put into words my gratitude for your quick actions. So many people classify heroes in the context of movie stars or sports figures, contexts of talent and skills. Who are the true heroes? We intend to raise our son to understand what it really means to be a hero. Heroes are the people around us that unconditionally sacrifice for the well-being of others. He will know your name just as I do. Heroes are people like you who gamble their life on a battlefield, whose sacrifices provide the many freedoms we enjoy. Someone who willingly comes to the aid of another to save the life of a complete stranger. He can see us. Can you say hi, Richard?
Hi.
Kindness in the purest form. Not everyone gets to return home from war to hug their families again. My dad was one of the very fortunate. Your actions will forever be rooted in our family history. Without you, there would not be an us. I can assure you that my father has gone on to live every day in gratitude for the second chance at life he was given. He's a good man. He taught us not to take a single day for granted, because the next is not ever promised, to look for the sunlight in the cloud coverings. His gratitude for another day has been paid forward in so many ways, more notably through his dedication to coaching soccer for the last 40 years. He has taught kids and young adults lessons on and off the field, how to be good people. He tries with this one. His lessons go beyond the measure of skills. He shared his infectious optimism with everybody he meets. He reminds us to spread kindness at every opportunity. He has taught us from a young age to shake the hands of men and women in uniform and thank them for the sacrifices that they have made. I am so proud to call him my dad, my friend, my rock. Your heroism was a catalyst to so many positive and rewarding things in life, in his life. If I could shake your hand right now, I would. For now, I just want to say thank you from the very, very bottom of my heart on behalf of my entire family for finding my father that night and seeing that he was a life worth saving. Thank you, Richard, for serving. May love and happiness surround your family as it has ours. Stay safe. We thank you so much. Can you say bye, Chance?
Bye.
Thank you.
Richard, this is Ben, oldest son to Jean and Mary Warney. On May 5th, 1969, you selflessly came to the aid of a very badly wounded soldier on the field. In most cases, that soldier in that condition would not have survived. But if it wasn't for your heroic actions that evening, my dad would not have survived and lived to do all the things that he did and be here today. I mean, I wouldn't be here, none of my siblings would be here, and I wouldn't have the honor of being raised by what I honestly want to believe is the greatest father a kid could ever have. He's really an amazing person, and I can't thank you enough for what you did to save his life. Your family should be extremely proud. That being said, I want to congratulate you on this well-deserved, long-awaited award that you're receiving. And I also want to thank you for your service. You're an amazing man, Richard. The world needs more people like you. Thank you again. God bless.
Richard, this is Butch Henshaw. I just wanted to go over what the conversation we had at your dad's house that night, that we talked about how your dad was a strong-willed person, and we was really into Vietnam at that time, and it was a bad time to be in Vietnam, and the things that was going on. And when I first met your dad, we were guarding a river, a road that the river went over. We had to guard it for most of the time in that place. And then we have to go out on little teams at four and stuff like that, that we'd have to take a point man, which I was a point man for your dad at that time. It was scary at that time, where you didn't know if you was going to get blowed up or anything like that. But your dad is a strong-willed person, straightforward, and when he made decisions, he made the decisions the right way. And I honor him today for that. He's a good Marine, and he will always be in my heart as a good Marine. And things that he had done, and I probably, if I didn't remember mentioning it, that one time we was in a bad firefight and we had a lot of casualties. And this one guy that Richard looked over there, and he was choking on his own blood. And Richard went into action right then and done a trachea on him, which it really saved his life, you know. And that's your dad. He's a outstanding Marine, and he's an honorable Marine. And he's my best friend, and he'll always be my best friend. And I just wanted y'all to let you know that I always love your dad, because he's a good man. And God bless y'all, and Happy New Year to you and all your family, and then all your brothers and sisters too, that they have a blessed New Year's. And talk to y'all later. Bye.
Richard, Mike Braxton, Echo Company 2-1. One of the highlights of my life was finally meeting the Marine, the man who saved the life of my boyhood friend and fellow 2-1 Marine, Gene Warney. Sometimes the Corps takes a long time after the shooting stops to pay homage to a true hero like you. Congrats, Richard. Well deserved. And Cpl Fi.
Hello, Rich, Debbie, and the Wosnik family. This is Mario. For those of you that don't know me, I'm the treasurer of Vietnam Veterans of 2nd Battalion, 1st Marines. It is an honor for me to be part of this dedication to Rich. I wasn't there when it happened, but I was told by Michael, and I am really proud to be part of this battalion, to have Marines like you. What you did was absolutely heroic, and I definitely appreciate it. I am proud to tell the story to other people and let them know that I was part of this this great battalion. Rich, I miss you. I hope that you will be at the next reunion. And in the meantime, you take care of yourself and Cpl Fi, brother.
Well, you don't look a whole lot different.
Happy birthday to you.
Congratulations on your well-deserved award. Now, take off your pack. You've deserved it. Cpl Fi, brother.